Hello everyone, this is Ishita Agarwal. Welcome to Text Connect, a learning center for textile. Today we'll be discussing the classification of the textile fibers. Hope you like the video. Now let us begin.
So before we begin classifying fibers, let us first know where does fiber come from? What are the various sources of fibers? The natural sources are cellulose and protein, and the major source for the synthetic fibers are petroleum, natural gas deposits and coal. So the cellulose fibers. Now they act as a skeleton to the plants. Bundle of fibers are bound together by natural gum and resins to the various parts of the plants, providing them strength. Now the protein fibers, they are found in the growing tissues of plants and animals. In case of petroleum, natural gas and coal, they yield different saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons, which serve as the major raw material for production of synthetic fibers. Now let us move on to the classification of fibers. Textile fibers are broadly classified into natural and machine-made fibers. Now the fibers that are of natural origin are natural fibers, which are further divided into three categories: vegetable fibers, animal fibers and mineral fibers. The machine-made fibers are synthesized and processed artificially and are further divided into three: regenerated fibers, synthetic fibers and inorganic fibers. Now let us have a look at the classification of natural fibers in detail. Now they are divided into vegetable, animal and mineral fibers, and I think it will be very clear from the name itself that which fiber falls under which category. So the fibers that are derived from plants and various parts of the plants are vegetable fibers, and they are further divided depending on the part of the plant from which we get a fiber. So the first one is the seed fiber. So this has the maximum cellulose content, and the major seed fibers that are most widely used all over the world since thousands of years are cotton and kapok. Now bast or stem fiber. So these are found in the inner bark of the plant stem. Major ones are jute, flax and hemp. The fibers that run lengthwise through the leaves, giving them additional strength, are the leaf fibers. Sisal, pineapple and banana are the major leaf fibers. The next one is the fruit fibers. The husk in which a fruit is encased is sometimes fibrous. Can you all guess which fruit produces a fibrous husk? Yes, it's coconut. The husks are fibrous and produces coir fiber. India and Sri Lanka is the largest producer of coir fiber. Now moving on to animal fibers. They are found as the hair of mammals or as a secretion. Wool, camel hair, angora, mohair, cashmere are all hair fibers. Cashmere is a Kashmiri goat, which we commonly know as the pashmina wool. Silk is a secretion fiber. Now if we talk about mineral fibers, we have asbestos, which is a group of fibrous silicate materials. This is all for the natural fibers. Now let us move on to the machine-made fibers. So machine-made fibers divided into three: synthetic fibers, regenerated fibers, and inorganic fibers. Now, from World War II, there has been a thrust to produce synthetic materials that was mostly derived from petrochemicals. So the textile industry also saw a rise of the synthetic fibers during the very same time. Nylon was the first synthetic fiber that was available to the public around the 1930s. So these synthetic fibers, they are basically created by a process of polymerization, which you all know is combining the monomers to form long chain polymers. Now depending on these monomers, they are further classified as polyamides, which consist of nylon and aromatic amides. Now these aromatic amides, they have a very high melting fiber, which is Normex, and that is used to make a fireproofing suit. And Kevlar, which is a very high strength fiber that is used in the making of bulletproof jackets. The next one is polyester, that is one of the most widely used fiber these days. Then we have polyolefins, that of polyethylene and polypropylene. And the next group of fibers is the vinyl fibers. And the important fibers in this group are acrylic, Teflon, and modacrylic. Now moving on to regenerated fibers. So when the natural sources, they are treated and reproduced into fibers, they are known as the regenerated fibers. The cellulose and protein, they are dissolved in chemicals and then fibers are extracted from it. So for the cellulose based fibers, rayon is a basic term that is used for all the machine made fibers that have a cellulose base. So we have viscous rayon, cupramonium rayon, acetate and triacetate. The other one, that is the protein regenerated fibers. So they are made by dissolving proteins like casein from milk and the soya bean protein and chemicals that forms the spinning solution, and then fibers are extracted from it. And last we have the inorganic fibers. So most of the textile fibers, they are from an organic source. But we do have some fibers that are of great importance to mankind that are from non-organic sources. So these non-organic materials are shaped into fibers and then used for various applications. For example, glass fiber and ceramic fibers. That's all from my side.
I hope you like the video. If there are any doubts or questions, please put them out in the comment section below or reach out to us through Instagram or email. If you like the video, please share with all your textile peeps and subscribe to TexConnect. We'll be coming back with new videos very soon. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy.